There's just no question what this man should do.
Grandma and Grandpa.
Take all the time lost, all the days that I cost. Take what I took and give it back to you. All this time we were waiting for each other. All this time
Mom and Dad.
Kathy, it's a special day.
Take all the time lost, all the days that I cost. Take what I took and give it back to you. All this time we were waiting for each other. Take all the time lost, all the days that I cost. Take what I took and give it back to you. All this time we were waiting for each other. All this time I was waiting for you. We got all these words, can't face them.
Please be seated. Suzanne Brianna Shockey. This is the last time we'll call you by that name. Through their time together, they have come to realize that their personal dreams, their hopes, their goals are more attainable and more meaningful by fulfilling them together in commitment to each other. And through the combined effort and mutual support that's provided in love and commitment and family, we celebrate that they are becoming husband and wife. I believe that marriage is the most important of all earthly relationships. It should be entered into reverently, thoughtfully, and with a full understanding of its sacred nature and sacred power. Your marriage must stand by the strength of your love for each other, by the power of the faith that you have in each other and the faith you have in God. Just as threads of different colors of thread are woven together in opposite directions to form a beautiful tapestry. So the two of you and your separate lives are now merged together and will make a beautiful marriage. And all of us here who are gathered believe that because we've loved watching you. And Matthew, do you bring your whole self to this marriage without reservation? Who gives this woman to this man?
Her mother.
Let's bow in prayer.
Symbolically brings two hearts together. So if you're here with a loved one and want to hold hands with them, feel free to do so. This is called The Blessing of the Hands by Reverend Daniel L. Harris.
A lot going into this, especially because it's been extended by another year. A lot of stress, a lot of plans, a lot of to-do lists and checklists and spreadsheets, etc. So for this next few minutes, I'd like you to be very present and very mindful that you're present right here. So let's start that by going back and remembering your first date. And how probably awkward it was. Probably same kind of butterflies that are down there right now, but different, maybe not as professional as they are right now. Awkward in that you're trying to figure out things to talk about, how to get to know each other, etc. Got it with you? So take that forward then to the next date. We don't have to go into detail about a next date, but let's fast forward it to that time period, whether it was in a date situation or in your own time together, separately. When you kind of had that first thought that, you know what? This guy's different, or this girl's different. There's something more special here. And this might be the one. Bring that here and get it here in front of you. And then complement all of that with the time when you were certain and you left the scene that evening or that day and you had made a formal commitment to each other. And here you are. And we have all had the pleasure and the joy of watching all that happen. And we now celebrate that with you. So as this short little message, I want to just give to you now three little primary points about your marriage life, your married life, and what you can give to commitment to each other in faith. So first, in faith, that faith is your foundation. It's faith in God. It's faith that good will conquer evil. It's also faith that you get to be a part of the good conquering evil. And it's also, including those two, faith in each other. Faith is that mysterious bond that holds us together, that if we identify, is no longer faith. I'll give you a little example of that. If I told you right now that I had a small pocket knife in my pocket, one that would fit on the plane, it's orange, and it has a little curve in it, and it's a Case XX blade. You would have a choice of believing me or not believing me until I pull it out and you see it, in which time I've destroyed your faith. You no longer have faith in what I have asked you to believe in. It's now a reality. That mysterious piece right before you know is the mystery of the faith that you have now in each other that God holds to bond you together. That higher power that is stronger than your individual will. And that's a strong higher power for the two of you combined. I can tell you that right now. There's a lot of will right there. So along with faith, complement that with family. These are two wonderful families that are coming together and joining together. Combined, salted, if you will, with some great friendships and some great friends that are gathered here. Those are the second piece of your foundation. The door of your marriage is forgiveness. And if you had to interview anyone who's married in the room this evening, they will share in the reality that it's forgiveness that's the glue of a married life. If the world in which we live showed more forgiveness and less judgment, then Jesus would have a lot less time staying away and would call us back sooner, I believe. So just close with this and we'll move on to the vows as you compliment each other and continue to. C.S. Lewis makes this beautiful statement about marriage. saying the idea of marriage from Christ's perspective is that the husband and the wife are to be regarded as a single organism. And it's believed that when he said this, he was not making a sentiment, but stating a fact. And the fact is that just as one might state that a violin and a bow are one musical instrument, the inventor of the human machine was telling us that it's two halves, as male and female, made to combine together in pairs, not simply on a physical level or on a sexual level, but as a totally combined unity and oneness. So C.S. Lewis says, think about the violin, maybe a beautiful Stradivarius, one of the most, you know, worth tens of thousands of dollars, a violin that cannot be complemented by another violin. That doesn't make sense. But, and a bow not complemented by another bow, but the violin needs the bow, and the bow needs the violin. And together, the two different instruments fulfill their purpose together, just as you two find each other as Midwesterners in Arizona. Compliment each other. A beautiful analogy, and it's my wish for your marriage. I give you this ring as a sign of my love and faithfulness. I give you this ring as a sign of my love and faithfulness. There's traditional words here that are very, very beautiful, and I love saying them, that you two have declared your consent before God, before these people. We ask that God will confirm your covenant and fill you with his grace. And now that Matt and Suzanne have given themselves to each other by solemn vows, by the joining and giving of receiving of rings, I pronounce that, and we can celebrate, that they are husband and wife with the blessing of God. Those whom God has joined together, let no one separate. Amen. Did you seal your marriage with a kiss? Share Holy Communion with the two of them today. We ask, Lord, that you will bless these elements that the blood of Christ.
You're simply the best.
Let's bow in prayer together. Now introduce to you the, for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Matthew and Suzanne.